Hi guys, my name is Michael Smith and I'm the co-founder of Soshio. I'm originally from Zurich, from a little place called Rishikon. I studied business economics at Zurich and then later moved over and got my master's degree in St. Gallen before coming to this great big city called New York. Why New York? Let me see. Well, first of all, just because growing up, I used to listen to a lot of Frank Sinatra. And obviously, we all know that phrase that he says, if you can make it there, you can make it anywhere. And I really truly believed in that as a kid, and to this day. New York is a fascinating place. It's full of energy and full of people believing that they have the next $1 million idea. There's a lot of competition here, a lot of smart people here. And I wanted to be a part of this great city. I wanted to be a part of this energy and participate and thrive in this. So I decided at one point to pack up my bags and leave the beautiful home country and try my luck here in the big city of New York. How did it get started with Soshio? Well, I started Soshio based on a need. I used to work in global marketing and I had to come up with marketing strategies for various countries. And one of the biggest countries and focus was China. Unfortunately, I had data only on the rest of the world. Basically, I had data on consumers from Russia, Brazil, and everything else, but I did not have data when it came to China. So I thought there must be a tool out there. There must be some kind of company out there that can provide me this real-time data on what Chinese social media users, for instance, are saying about a specific topic, brand, product, that will help me then build my marketing strategy and communication processes. So having identified the need, I had the privilege of meeting some great individuals that were looking for opportunities to build a company. And we teamed up and formed and founded Soshio. Soshio is a data analytics company that allows companies to clients to understand what Chinese social media users are saying about their product, about their company, about any specific topic of interest in real time. What we do is we track a specific keyword, pull it from all different sources on the Chinese web, and then analyze it based on sentiment. So does it mean meaning positive, negative? We also analyze what kind of emotions are being expressed. Are people expressing desire for something, love, joy, or hate, sorrow, sadness? And we then provide that kind of information to marketers and analysts around the world to better understand these Chinese consumers and better tailor their product developments and their messaging developments and marketing strategies to the Chinese consumers' needs. I guess I would say it's the fact that we Swiss tend to undersell. We're humble, meaning we tend to let our products, our work speak for ourselves versus creating too much bells and whistles around it. Versus the Americans, they know how to present something. The Americans know how to sell something. So they put a lot of these, they do the jazz hands, the jazz dance when presenting. And though for a lot of us, back home in Switzerland, that might sometimes be distracting or we think, well, that's just show and dance. Here in the States, it's really part of doing business. If you're not able to sell, you won't stand out. There are a lot of people competing for the attention of a lot of investors or other people here, for clients here. So it is expected that you do the song and dance, that you do a great presentation, and that you are able to show your work in a great light to really stand out. And if you do not, people might assume that you don't have actually such a great product. So it's that component that I've learned here is you have to somehow be loud. You have to be able to stand in front of people and really present and do a show. Otherwise, you will just go under in the masses. Swiss Drinks. Swiss Drinks, as the name says, is basically a community of people that that get together once a month. The premise is that we discover the city together by going each month to a different location. The locations are bars or restaurants or rooftops. And basically give everyone the opportunity to speak Swiss German for once a month, or French or Italian, of course. I haven't had Romansh just yet. And also exchange experiences, get tips and tricks on how to survive in this big city, and from fellow residence. I'm Swiss and I've been living here for a couple of years. And or just hear about, or just simple networking as well. The community is really a mix of people that have been living here for a couple of years to people that are actually just tourists here. We have people from various industries, from not only banks and insurances, but we also have marketing. We have artists, musicians, all kind of interesting people. So, you know, if you want to join, send me an email at mike@getsoshio.com, and I will gladly put you on the list, on the distribution list that we send out every month.